Hello, I'm Xu Peng from Chile's Academy of Sciences. Today, I'm going to introduce our research work, Cooper, testing the binding code of scripting languages with cooperative mutation. It's a joint work with Yinhao Wang from Tianjin, Honghu from Princeton University, Brice Su from Chile's Academy of Sciences. Nowadays, scripting languages are integrated into document processing programs. For example, PDF and JavaScript, Office document and VBA code. HTML and JavaScript, Xcode and Python AdaPro. Embedded scripts are usually used to manipulate the content elements of a document. Vulnerabilities in embedded scripting languages are very dangerous. Attackers can exploit vulnerabilities in this system to execute abuse code and take control of the system. And every year, many vulnerabilities are discovered in this system. So it's essential for us to design a new effective method to find such bugs. First of all, I'm going to introduce the structure of a document with embedded script code. This kind of document usually consists of two parts, native objects and script code. The native objects make up the main content of the document, such as the pictures, annotations, paragraphs, input box, and tables. Script code is an interpreted language embedded in a document. When application opens a document, it first passes the native objects and then interpreted and executes the script code. To bridge the gap between native objects and the script code, binding there is usually used to transfer data and transform representation. In the interaction between native objects and the scripts, secondly, the interaction between native objects and the script code often introduce bugs. Specifically for efficiency, nowadays applications are usually developed in low-level languages such as C and C++. So there is a gap between a high-level scripting language and a low-level application. In addition, scripts engine and the application are usually developed independently. So in order to bridge the gap between two sets, a binding layer is usually used to transfer data and transform representation. In this process, vulnerabilities are usually caused by the inconsistency between the native objects and the script code. However, previous works haven't been able to effectively find such bugs, mainly because they only mutated the script code without any mutation in native objects. We take a vulnerability discovered by Cooper to demonstrate our concept. It's a heap overflow in Adobe Acrobat. Successfully exploit this vulnerability can achieve remote code execution. It's so severe that we were awarded with $2,500 bounty for this particular vulnerability. It has been patched by Adobe before our paper submission. So then let's see how to check this vulnerability. First of all, in native objects, we must insert one extra element into finance wireless array. Then in scripts code, we must utilize JavaScript to change the zoom type of document to RefW. So as you can see, to trigger this vulnerability, we must mutate both native objects and the scripts code. The traditional one-dimension file mutation file cannot find this sort of vulnerability. Inspired by this vulnerability, we want to design a new effective method to find such bugs that are related to both native objects and the script codes and the script code. Our solution is cooperative mutation. It's very straightforward. We just mutate both native objects and the script code in a cooperative manner. So we come to the problem: how to achieve cooperative mutation. First of all, we need to infer the relationship between native objects and the script code. And then we will utilize the infer the relationship to get a mutation. Specifically, if a script API has some potential connected with objects in a document, we will assign these objects a high priority for mutation. Otherwise, if a script API has low related objects in a document, we will randomly choose some objects for mutation. While our method is very straightforward, there are also several challenges to be solved. The first challenge is how to infer the relationship between our native objects and script code. Once we have the relationship, we also need to solve the second challenge, how to use the infer relationship to get a mutation. However, when we solve these two challenges, we encounter with another problem. There are too many native objects. That means we will have a huge search space for infer relationship and get a mutation. It's not doable. To solve this problem, we must reduce the search space. So how to reduce the search space? We plan to category all native objects into different categories according to their semantic features. So then we can infer the relationship and get a mutation with a relatively small number of object classes. So we come to the challenge zero. How to class the objects into semantic similar classes. This figure presents our view of our solution. It has three components. The first component is object clustering. It clusters a large number of native objects into a small number of object classes. Once we have the object classes, we need to infer the relationship between object classes and the scripting API. Is the purpose of our second component, relationship inference. It utilizes a statistical method to infer the relationship. Finally, we come to the third component, relationship get mutation. It utilizes the infer relationship to do cooperative mutation. I will show all components in detail. The first part of our solution is object clustering. Object usually consists of some attributes. Each attribute is a pair of name and object. Through our observation, the name of object usually carries some semantic information. So in the first step, we just clustering objects with their name. It's very simple, we just put objects with different names into different categories. However, in some color cases, clustering objects with their name may not be correct. For example, there are some universal names such as kids and parents. So in order to get a fine-grained object classes, we need to split and merge object classes with their attribute similarity. Specifically, we use a dense formula to calculate the similarity between object classes. If the similarity is less than the threshold value, we split a bigger class into some small one. If the similarity is greater than the threshold value, we merge some small classes into a bigger one. Through these two steps, we finally get a fine-grained object classes. The second part of our solution is relationship inference. It takes two steps to infer the relationship. In the first step, we do execution logging for all samples and divide the element into two sets, success set and a failure set. Specifically, we prepare a testing code and insert the testing code into the orange sample and produce a new sample. Then we use the application to open a new sample. If the testing code successfully found some related element in the document, we will put the orange sample into success set. If the testing code cannot find the related elements or produce some error, we will put the orange sample into failure set. So in this first step, we divide all samples into success set and failure set. After we divided all samples into success set and failure set, then we will utilize a statistical method to infer the relationship between object classes and the scripting API. And finally, we get a relation map. As you can see from this map, the success rate is the percentage of samples that contain this class of object in the success set. The failure rate is the same percentage in failure set. The diff value is the difference between success rate and failure rate. We think the devalue represents the strength of the strength of relationship between object class and the scripting API. In the second part of the solution, we have got a relationship between scripting scripting API and object classes. So in this part, we will utilize the relation map to get a mutation. First of all, we determine a target API group. Then we take a traditional method to generate a script code. For native objects, we get a seed sample and select objects in this sample for mutation. Specifically, we refer to the relation map and design algorithm to calculate mutation probability for each object in the seed sample. In general, the mutation probability is positively correlated with the relationship strength of the relationship. Then we select objects with mutation probability and mutate the selected objects with three mutation strategies: attribute mutation, whole object mutation, and universal mutation. Finally, we synthesize the mutated objects and script code together and produce a final input. That's all of our solution. For implementation, we developed a Cooper in 4,300 lines of Python code. Cooper also utilizes some open source library. It uses PyPDF2 to pass format PDF format and use zip file and XML to pass the word format. For script generation, we utilize Domato and improve it with protocol level template. And currently, Cooper supports two formats, PDF format and Word format. It's notable that Cooper is extensible and portable. We can easily add some new features to Cooper and can also apply Cooper to some new document formats with limited manual efforts. We evaluate Cooper in five aspects. New bugs in real-world program, clustering occurrence, inference occurrence. We also compare the capabilities of bug finding and edge finding in different configurations and tools. We applied Cooper to Adobe Acrobat, FocusRadar, and Microsoft Word. We totally found 134 previous under bugs in these three real-world software. We totally got 33 CVE numbers, and 59 bugs have been fixed. We were awarded with $22,000 bounty. All these bugs are related to 90 APIs in 11 objects. Is the object class reasonable? We choose one object class generated by Cooper and compile it to PDF specification. We find this object class is very similar to page object in PDF. For example, all objects in this class has a type attribute, and all layer values are page. As you can see from the right, the page attribute is a required attribute, and its value must be page. There are also many other similarities. This result shows the currency of our clustering algorithm. Is the inference relationship reasonable? We manually compare part of our relationship generated by Cooper with the PDF specification. As you can see from the slides, the left is the part of our relationship generated by Cooper. The right is some related information from PDF specification. The IP attribute is the appearance of annotation. The FM attribute is the form X object that constructs the appearance object. The allows attribute is the main existence form of allotation. This is also prove the occurrence of our relationship inference algorithm. To fully understand the ability of Cooper, we prepared five versions and compared them in bug finding and edge finding. Cooper 4 is a full feature of configuration. It utilizes the inference relationship to get a mutation. Cooper random doesn't use ID inference relationship. It just randomly choose some objects on the scripting API for mutation. Cooper objects are only mutated native objects without any mutation in script code. On the contrary, Cooper script only mutated script code without any mutation in native objects. The last experiment is conducted with a previous work, Domato. Since Domato is originally designed to test the general JavaScript code, we add a JavaScript template for PDF and VBA template for Word document. We apply the work configurations on Adobe Acrobat and record their bug finding history in 1 week. As you can see from this figure, Cooper 4 found 18 bugs in 1 week, which is the most among all configurations. This is to prove our concept that cooperative mutation is essential to finding bugs in binding code. We also apply the work configurations on focus rate. We also do the experiments on focus rate. The result is very similar to Adobe Acrobat. Cooper 4 always found the most bugs. To test the edge finding ability, we apply the work configurations on Adobe Acrobat and record their edge finding ability, edge finding history in 1 week. We both record script coverage and native coverage. As you can see from this figure, Cooper 4 always found the most coverage in both tabs. We also do the experiments on focus reader and script API and Microsoft Word. The result is also very similar to Adobe Acrobat. Cooper 4 always found the most coverage. This result can also be a proof of a concept. In conclusion, we propose cooperative mutation to test the binding code of scripting language. Our system, Cooper, found 134 bugs in Adobe Acrobat, focus rate on Microsoft Word. And we totally gained 33 CVE numbers, and we were awarded with $22,000 bounty. And now Cooper is open source at this website. Thanks for listening. I'm ready for questions.
Okay.